Hey guys, Tom here. Maybe I never told you this, but as a kid, I was really big on soldering and building my own gear. So since it's a really nice day, I've set up here, ta-da, my workstation. So you see a bunch of shit here laying around. You see some professional tools, and this is actually something that I just completed. This is a thing that I'm working on, and actually, next, I'm gonna build a new 19-inch case because I built something here. So I was testing some sort of like smaller reverb unit, which is surrounded by a chip by Accutronics. It's called the BTDR2H. It's a really good chip that generates a sort of like a spring reverb kind of reverb, and with a few electronic parts, 30, 40 electronic parts and a bunch of wires and potentiometers, that's what they call these things, you can create a really, really good sounding digital reverb. This chip is being used by a lot of pedals out there. And this, ladies and gentlemen, this tiny little thing here, this, is something like the fuzz phase that Jimi Hendrix used. And so just a few parts, and I'm gonna test this one later. So what we see here is a little 9-volt power supply, but for testing I have two units here that can deliver any kind of voltage that I want, and amps. I've got two of them because some of the electronics schematics that I'm making have a negative power and a positive power. So you need two things for that. I've got here a small voltage meter. I've got my oscilloscope that you sometimes need to measure things. And here I've got my soldering station where I can set the temperature of the soldering iron. Here we have some miniature screwdriver set that you need for all the various different things. I've got some extra wire, some professional tinner for soldering. Here we have, let's call them insulation socks. So you put it over a wire that is soldered, and then with a lighter underneath, it's going to shrink, and then you cannot ever touch that again. So to build these kind of pedals that I'm working on, I'm totally fine using like the generic parts that you can buy just with any store. So the general chips that have been used a lot, like for instance the dual op amp, the 4558 has been used a lot in electronics things. Basic condensers, electrodes, ceramic, resistors, potentiometers, so you can basically design your own value. Some print boards so you can test stuff out that you want to build. A bunch of resistors, some cables, diodes, LED lights that are 9 volts with different colors. So some of the things that I built are more complex in nature, and we'll get to that in another episode. But the interesting thing is that these guitar pedals only use a handful of small parts. It all works with 9 volts, so it's safe. You don't get shocked. You don't die if you touch anything. Very different though when you build a tube amp, which I'm also going to do an episode about because I am building a tube amp, and how to do that. But don't try that at home. And it's so remarkable how relatively cheap you can build your own stuff. So let's start with the first bit. So this is the front panel right here. And so this whole case, this is going to be, so it's going to turn out like that. But this whole 19-inch case is, if you buy a few of them, it's only $35. And to buy some of these generic, oh, I got this actually for you guys to show this. So this box is $25. And it has, of each thing that you potentially could need for building guitar pedals, it has like a set of these basic parts. So you can easily build 10, 20, 30 effect pedals with just $24 of parts. So people that are into trying this for themselves, please go for it. There's a lot of like interesting websites that you can find where you can find information about how to build your own pedal. So now I've got a smooth in and out. I'm going to take them out again, because now I'm going to add the handles to it, like you see here, and then it goes through the panel. So let's do this again. But now I know for sure. So the first one is always like a little tricky. That's Enzo. Enzo talking. He always joins the conversation. In life and afterlife. You can see these tiny little slides here. That's where the bottom plate will go in and the top plate will go in. This is your bottom plate. Beautiful piece of metal. And we're going to slide this in right here. And since I left just enough room, so you can create a secondary plate within the 19-inch rack. Like for instance, if you want to have a bunch of controllers here that are not part of the front panel. Some people put it in front of the front panel so you can take the front panel off, but then all the electronica is kind of like soldered to the front here with just meters sticking out to put the knobs on, but the front panel has nothing connected to it. It's on the inside panel. Maybe you want to put the front panel all the way here, and here you want to have your high voltage transformers with potentially even the tubes, so they're kind of like locked away from where you want to work potentially, so you're not putting potentially yourself in danger of the high voltage part of your circuitry. The other cool thing is that what I have here, I'm currently not using this, but let me show it to you what it is. These are two rails that you can put into your 19-inch box, and you can use them to put print boards on. Not every 19-inch rack that you buy offers this, but this is the principle. So basically, you're going to sit down, you can slide these into these little rails here, like this. And it would be, it's the most effective if you do this with the back case off. So you slide them in on the back, and then you put them in. Right now, I can't get them in because the panel is already screwed on, but I'm just going to show you the idea. Okay, so this is the idea, that you can screw your print boards on here so they're protected from the bottom and they sit here steadily. So you can have one here, you can have one here, and all the print boards are here. Like I said, I am not using that system. I use tiny plastic tubes that are mounted to the bottom with like M2 screws and nuts. And then a print sits on there, like away from the bottom, on a solid spot, and I can rearrange whatever I want. So let's just now put the top plate on. Boom. And there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. A 19-inch case. That is now ready for design. So for instance, if you have an electronic circuitry, and you you have your knobs, and for instance you have your in and outputs, you can start designing how you want this to be. So for instance, let's take a ring here. Is this the right ring? I'm gonna find out really quick. Okay, let's say for instance this is gonna be your input. Okay, we put this thing here, and then this is a parameter. This is a parameter. This is a parameter. And let's say here we're going to make a nice meter. And this is a parameter. And this is a parameter. And there's like one over here. And one over there. Let's say this is what you would like to design. I usually make a picture of it. And then I have like measuring tape. So you see where you want things, and then you can measure it out. You can do the same thing like this and take a picture like that, so you could roughly see. Oh, and then you basically, I use like that blue tape that you use for painting, you know, to make sure that you not mess up the walls or the whatever. So I cover it with that, and then with a liner, I'm lining out exactly where I want the holes to be, and then with a power drill and a very unique drill set for these very, because for electronica, you sometimes need really big holes. Stuff like that. You see, that's even thicker than my thumb. Sometimes you need that for electronica. So these are relatively new because they die relatively quick when you drill these big of a hole. So I used this one a lot yesterday, the day before yesterday, for that one over there. That is the plan for today, to finish some of the work that I'm working on with this particular stuff. So the little reverb unit that I just showed you is one of the 8 modules that I have built that are going to go in here. And I'm just going to design it a little bit, see what I want to do with the meter, and just start drilling some holes and start slowly building everything into the box. So that is going to be my day, and I'll see you soon.